Hey, Kev, what are you looking at?
Ain't that pretty? Got a request the other day for a copper video. Wow.
Copper welding?
Copper welding. Yeah, I kind of knew I could do this with the TIG. I just never had the call for it. And I just tried it one day, and I'll be darned, it works pretty good. So, here, let me show you. So this is just a little piece of quarter-inch thick copper plate that I had left over from a different project that I worked on. So I cut off a couple little pieces, chamfered the edges so we get a nice weld in there, and I thought I'd just put them together and run a little bead. Now, most of the time, you run down to the welding store and you get the proper rod, but because this is just for fun, this is just a piece of scrap that's going right back in the scrap bucket when I get done. What I found works well with copper, this is actually a piece of Romex electrical wire. I had some left over from the remodeling on the studio. I thought, well, what the heck? And just strip it out. It works just fine for what I'm doing here. Don't go using it on your important projects. So put your helmet on. We'll make a spark here. Take your helmet up. See how red it got? That's how much heat, because the copper conducts heat so well. So that was 200 amps to get started, and then I could back off on the pedal to about 150 amps to keep the weld going because of that quarter inch copper, because it was just conducting so much heat and just sinking it right into the table. I needed that much to get it hot and keep it going. Well, you can do copper. Copper's pretty easy, actually, as long as you got a TIG, as long as you got some decent rod, or whatever you can find. Clean it up, make sure it's nice and clean, just like aluminum, make sure you got a good joint. Go for it. See you next time.